Celsius. 2.4 Celsius. Altimeter 300 niner inches of mercury.
0.09er.
To the altitude 3,400 feet.
Okay, so we're taxiing runway 25. Just set our altimeter setting. Turn that radio off. And pretty soon we'll be doing our run up and our takeoff. Hey. All right, so here we are on our takeoff roll. We're going 40 knots. About 65 knots, I'll start pulling back on the yoke. 60, 65, you can start to feel the airplane light. And there we go.
Auburn traffic, Cessna 982 taking active runway 25, straight out departure, Auburn.
Met 3 traffic, RV-282, overhead to field, turning.
Okay, we're just leaving Auburn Airport. We're at 2,600 feet, and our altimeter as we climb is indicating we're going up, and the atmospheric pressure is lower, and that's how it works, just like a barometer. As you go up, pressure gets less, and it converts that to feet. Yeah, cool, there's a Cessna coming in on the left 45 to Auburn. And we can see the Sacramento Valley today, a little hazy out here.
Okay, we're back on the ground. It was a great flight. We flew from Auburn to Sacramento. I wanted to talk about how we set that altimeter because it went pretty quickly. All right, so for starters, throughout the day, throughout really the from an hour to hour basis, the barometric pressure can change on us, and so we have to calibrate it for that elevation of the airfield. A couple things that could happen. One is, let's say a high pressure moves in. Now, what is that again? So that's air sinking, okay? So maybe we get more dense molecules. That would change, in this case here, it would make it seem as if we were going down in elevation. So it would actually make this long hand start to move this direction. And maybe say we're at 1,300 feet or something like that. So we, and of course, Auburn's always the same elevation, right? It's about 1,500 feet. So a storm could do that. I mean, sorry, high pressure could do that, or a storm would make it go the opposite way because it thinks all of a sudden that it's gone up in elevation. So those are the two things. There's probably other things, but those are the biggies that can change the altimeter from day to day. So I said right in here, and it said it was 30.09er, and so I just simply moved this black knob right here to make it line up right here. Okay, so these two lines lined up, and it then shows me it at 1,500 feet, which is our field elevation. And the second thing that happened is we took off and we climbed out of Auburn, and we got to, let's say, 3,500 feet. Then the barometric pressure was dropping, and sure enough, the longer hand here would go around. The shorter hand gets to 2,000, then to 3,000, and then right here in between it would have been right here, okay? And then we also would, so we'd have 3,500, the long hand would be right there where it is right now. And that's simply how it just simply reads barometric pressure through these gauges that are just these little holes on the side of the airplane. It's as simple as that. It's a very simple system. It's been working for a long time. It's in small planes, and it's also in large planes.